Good morning. I am Dr. Nipen Saikia. I am a senior consultant gastroenterologist at PSRI Hospital, New Delhi. Recently, we have celebrated World NASH Day, Non-Alcoholic Fatty Liver Day. As a public awareness program, today I am going to speak briefly about non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, why it is important to know about non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, what are the risk factors for non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, what are the symptoms, how to diagnose, is there any treatment of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, can it be prevented? I will answer all these questions. So what is non-alcoholic fatty liver disease? We know that significant amount of alcohol intake causes liver disease, liver cirrhosis. But it is observed that people who do not take alcohol or minimal alcohol, they also develop similar type of changes in the liver over a period of time due to deposition of fat. This group of people with deposition of fat in the liver is called fatty liver disease or non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. It is a spectrum of disease. It starts with a simple deposition of fat, we call fatty liver or steatosis. 80% of this fatty liver is non-progressive, benign, but 15 to 20% of this fatty liver progress over a period of time and they causes inflammation of the liver, which is called non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. Again, NASH is progressive and it may not progress also. Over a period of 10 years, people with NASH can develop scarring in the liver or fibrosis in the liver. Fibrosis is again partially reversible. And small group of people with a liver fibrosis progress to liver cirrhosis over a period of 10 to 15 years. And subsequently develops complication of cirrhosis like liver failure and hepatocellular carcinoma. If you see all over the world, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is one of the most important cause of chronic liver disease. In America, in USA, around 20% of population have non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. And all over the world, around 1.75 billion people are affected with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. In India, if you see, we have a 120 million people with fatty liver disease. And it is a silent epidemic. It is going to be the most common cause of liver disease in coming years and the most common cause of death due to liver disease. It occurs both in children and in adults. In the USA or Europe, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is one of the most common cause of liver disease in children. In our country also, both children and adults are affected with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. So what are the risk factors for development of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease? You see, yes, this fatty liver disease develops in certain group of peoples with certain risk factors. The common risk factors are type 2 diabetes mellitus, person with obesity, dyslipidemia, insulin resistance or metabolic syndromes. It can also occur after rapid weight loss or after cholecystectomies. Yes, it can occur thin people with some genetic predisposition also. What are the symptoms of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease? Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, most of the people are asymptomatic, diagnosed incidentally on liver function tests or ultrasound examination. Some people have some fat abdominal symptoms like right upper quadrant pain or dragging sensation or discomfort. But in children, it can present with an abdominal pain also. How to diagnose? If somebody has liver enzyme elevated on routine LFT or ultrasound, then we advise the patient to go for an ultrasound, and ultrasound shows fatty liver, deposition of fat in the liver. Then we should rule out other causes of raised liver enzymes, including hepatitis B and C. The gold standard for diagnosis of non-alcoholic fatty liver is liver biopsy. Liver biopsy can trace the disease, whether it is a simple steatosis or it is a non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, or there is a fibrosis or there is a cirrhosis. Is there any treatment for non-alcoholic fatty liver disease? No. There is no specific treatment for non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. As I told, 80% people have simple steatosis only. It doesn't require any treatment. Only simple measures like diet control or lifestyle modifications can reverse the process of fatty liver. But if people have, some people have NASH, then it needed intervention in the form of treatment. But there is no specific medications to treat non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. There are multiple drugs under trial, or we give as a trial drugs, and which have minimal to moderate effect in the reducing the liver enzymes, or some drugs have shown to reduce the liver fibrosis also. Can it be prevented? Yes. NASH is a non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is a preventable disease. It is a metabolic disease. We can prevent by doing simple measures like our lifestyle modification, dietary changes, weight reductions. Diet, we should avoid a high fat diet. We should avoid junk food. We should avoid diet containing high fructose contents. And simple lifestyle modification like exercise, daily exercise can reduce the deposition of fat and burn the extra fat in from our body. Minimum 40 to 60 minutes of exercise can prevent development of fatty liver disease. Weight loss is an important step in the management of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. It is shown that if you can lose weight around 7 to 10%, that then fatty liver, simple fatty liver, can be reversed, and there is improvement of liver histology also over a period of time. But that weight loss has to be sustained. So non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is an important cause of chronic liver disease, and it is going to be most important cause of liver disease in coming years. But good thing is that it is a preventable disease. But with a good lifestyle and regular exercise and weight loss, we can prevent non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Thank you.